Good morning, audience. Our play is called Emna Akadrina. So please enjoy our show. And before that, we will introduce ourselves first. My name is Joffrey. I play the role of Kosonsky in this drama.
My name is Lusisong. I play Dronsky in this drama.
My name is
Wang.
I play the role Anna, Karenina in this drama.
My name is Bill. I play the role of Levin, Konstantin Dmitrievich.
My name is Steven, and I play the role Karenina and as husband.
My name is Aiden, and I play the role as a Chris who reports Levin's winning.
My name is Oliver. I play the role of Oblonsky, and who is Anna's brother.
My name is Lilia. I play the role of Dolly.
This was delightful. only just not putting it into words, or even expressing it in one sort of way. Nice. Oh, nice. Oh. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, no, why have I done this to Dolly? No, she won't forgive me, and she can't forgive me. But what's to be done? What's to be done? Oh, oh dear, awful, oh dear, awful. How well things are going up till now. How well we got on. She was contented and happy in her children. I never interfered with her in anything. I let her manage the children and the house just as she liked. It's bad. It's bad having a governess in our house. That's bad. Oh, it's calmer, vulgar, if flirting with someone's governess. But after all, what a governess. And while she was in the house, I kept myself in hand. And the worst of it all is that she's already. But it seems that you love her having so much. What's to be done? What's to be done? Then we shall see. Are there any papers from the office?
Yes, sir. On the table. I took in to come on Sunday. Until then, I'll trouble you for the survey for last week.
Matthew?
Yes.
My sister Anna will be here tomorrow.
Oh, thank God. Alone or with her husband?
Alone. Is the room upstairs ready? Inform Daya where she should go.
Daya?
Yes. Give it to her and do what she tells you.
Daya couldn't mean to inform me that she is way away. And let us do what you like.
Match me?
Yes, sir. It's all right, sir. She will come around.
Come around?
Yes, sir. You do your part. God is merciful. Pray to God, sir. Pray to God.
You mustn't be excited. You must be calm. Also, many of you be quite stupid. Even the possible can go with her eyes. Got her.
Have you been here long? Thank you.
Me and last night yesterday. Sorry, today I just arrived. I was meaning to come and
I don't know if you could skate. And skate away. The situation is cut here that he was the best of skaters.
Oh yes. You were discovered passion. You know, I wanted the reservation.
It's everything
is passion, I think. Even anything bothering me, though, I don't have a right to ask you such questions.
Actually, nothing bothers me. Surely you might seem dull in the winter, aren't you?
No, I'm not dull. I'm just too busy, you know.
Are you going to stay in town for long?
I don't know.
How is it? You don't know?
I don't know. It depends on you.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, God. That's what God will have done. God, please, help me.
Can it be my fault? Have I done anything wrong? They talk of flirtation. I know it's not he that I love, but still, I'm happy with him. And he's so jolly. Only, why did he say that? Oh, no.
Did I just see you?
on, please. For goodness sake, please don't say anything about it. I know all about it. Oh, Mom, please don't say about it. It's so horrible to talk about it. Yes, I won't. But there's you no use in my telling you anything. And if I wanted to, I don't know what to say or how. I don't know. Constantly 11. So it is to be. My God, shall I myself really tell it to him? Can't tell him I don't love him. That will be a lie. What am I to say to him? That I love Count Wonski? No, it's impossible. I'm going away. No, it's not honest. What am I to be afraid of? I've done nothing wrong. What is to be, will be. I'll tell the truth. With him, one can be ill at ease. Here he is. Come in.
It's not time yet. I think he's too early. But this was just what I wanted to find you alone. I have told you that I didn't know whether I should stay here long or not, that it depended on you. That is when you have to I want you to say, I was coming here for you to be my wife.
That cannot be. Forgive me.
I should know you before. You are fine to yourself.
Yes, I do see your ticker, I suppose.
I still see that the first day after marriage burned with impatience to see you.
Is it not, Aquawell?
And is this all the reward for my reader?
It's quite well.
Ah, well, Quentin, I believe. You settled with your mother and returned with your son. You're back from leave, I suppose. Were there great many tears shared at Moscow party?
I hope. I may have the honor of calling on you.
Delighted. On Monday, we're both at home, most fortunately, so that I shall just have half an hour to meet you, so that I can prove my devotion.
There'll be too much stress and devotion for me to matter much. Tell me, how's your
Maria, he says he has been very good, but I must disappoint you, because he hasn't missed you as your husband has. And once more, mercy, our great dear Samuel will be delighted. And you know, if my woman tried to advise you, you should go and see her today. You know how she takes everything to heart, and she's anxious about Vronsky being brought together.
But you know I wrote to her.
Still, she will want to hear more details. Go and see her. And if you are not too tired, my dear, come here, he will take you to the carriage. Well, I'm going to the committee, but I don't want to be dinner at home alone. You won't know how I miss you.
I wanted to tell you, you behaved wrongly, very wrongly.
Do you suppose that I do not know I have acted so wrongly? But who was the cause of my doings?
What did you say that to me for?
Do you know what for?
That only shows you have no heart. What you spoke of just now was a mistake, and no love. Remember that you're forbidden your touch of the word, that hateful word. I long me to tell you this. I come on purpose this evening. No, I should meet you. I come to tell you that this must end. I have never blushed before anyone and forced me to feel blame for something. I want you to go to Moscow and ask my parents for forgiveness.
No, don't wish that.
If you love me, as you say, then do so that I may be at peace.
Don't you know that you're all my life to me? But I know no peace. And I cannot give to you as well. All my life and love. No. I cannot think of you and me apart. You and I are one to me. But I see no chance of peace. For you or for me, I just see the chance of despair, of wretchedness, or I see the chance of bliss. What bliss? Will it be? There's no chance of it.
Then do this for me. Never say such things to me. I never tell
friends. Friends? You know that we can never be friends. Whether to be the happiest or the richest, it's in your hands. No, I just ask only one thing. I ask for the right to hope, to suffer. That's what I'm doing. But even that cannot be. Please, command me to disappear. If my presence is distasteful to you, you should never see.
I don't want you to go.
So, leave everything as it is, and do not change anything.
table dinner.
You've seen nothing, of course. I asked nothing. Remember, there's only one happiness in my life. Yes, Anna. The world that you hate is so much. Anna, it's love.
Love. Why do you like the word is that it means too much to me? Far more than I can understand.
I must decide and put a stop to it. I must express my views and my decision. But express what? And after all, what has occurred? Now, of course, in this society, women can feel free to talk to whoever they please. And jealousy is both lower in myself and her. But still, I must put a stop to it. And the worst of it all is that, just now, when my great work is approaching completion, when I stand in need of ultimate peace and ultimate energy, suddenly, the worry, boredom. I'm not one of those guys who submits the uneasiness without having the force of character to face them. I must think it over, put it out of my mind, and make a decision. The question of her feeling, or what has passed, may be passing to her soul. That's not of my affair. That's a fear of her own conscience, which I can understand. My duty is clearly defined. As the head of the family, I'm the person bound in duty to guide her. Point out the danger I see, to warn her, or even use my authority. I must speak to her. I must express the following point. First, exposition of the value to be attached to public opinion. Secondly, exposition of the religious significance of marriage. Thirdly, if need be, reference to our song. And fourthly, reference to the unhappiness likely to cause.
You're going bad? What a wonder. It's there, Alexei Alexandrovich.
Anna, it's necessary for me to have a talk with you.
With me? Why? What is it? What about? Well, let's talk if it's still necessary. But it would be better to get a sleep.
Anna, I must warn you.
Warn me? Of what?
I want to warn you that through your thoughtlessness and lack of caution, you may cause yourself to be talked about in society. Your animated conversation is rough, attracts attention.
You're always like that. One time you don't like Maggie Dow, another time you don't like Maggie Lively. Or wasn't that? Does that offend you?
Anna, is this you? This is what I need to say to you, and I beg you to listen to it. I consider jealousy, and I shall never allow myself to be influenced by it. This evening, it was not I observed, but judging by the impression of the company that everyone observes, your conduct in the department was not altogether what should be desired.
I positively don't understand. You're not aware, Alexei Alexandrovich.
You're free at your own conscience, but I'm the person bound to guide you, point out to you your duty. Our life has been joined, not by man, but by God.
I don't understand a word, and, oh dear, how sleepy I am, and not you.
Pardon, for God's sake, don't speak like this. Perhaps I was mistaken, but trust me. All I say it's all because of my husband. And I love you.
I have nothing to say. And besides, it's really time to be in bed.
Let me say all I have to say. I'm your husband. I'm not speaking of myself. The most important person in this matter is our son and yourself. Maybe my word is a little bit unnecessary about this. If so, I beg you to forgive me. But if you have a little conscience, I beg you to sing a little.
Alexei Alexandrovich, really, I don't understand. It's late. It's late.
The cuckoo already.
Yes, the hare. It's coming.
What's that sound?
You don't know it? That's a hare. But you're not supposed to climb.
Oh, can I have your seat?
Here it is.
Oh, it's a bad shot from the red sparrow. Shh, it's flying.
Got it?
Isn't it time to go home?
That's simple, man. I do like you, man.
When do you leave Moscow?
I leave Moscow from some personal reason. It would be better than I even know it.
Alright.
Sima, how is your going to be whether your sister lost memories or when she's going to be?
She's never thinking of marriage. Pity's ill. The doctors have sent her abroad and they are positively afraid that she may not leave.
What? Yeah, how could it be? Huh? How is she?
Yes, what was that that was unpleasant? Pity's ill. It can't be helped. I'm very sorry.
I'm not the wife of my husband.
There is a way out of every position. We must keep our lives. Anything is better than the position that you are in. Of course, I see how you torture yourself over everything. The world, your side, and your husband.
I'm not aware of my husband. I don't know him. I don't think of him. He doesn't exist.
No, dear. You must be sincere. I know you. You care about him.
What's to be done, according to you?
Tell him everything and leave him.
Very well. Let us suppose I do that. You know the result of that would be. I can tell you all beforehand. You know another man and have entered into criminal interest with him. I warned you of the resort, the religious, the civil, and the domestic relations. You have not listened to me. Now I cannot let you degrade my name, and my soul, and more in the same styles. In general terms, child stay in a special manner, and with all the distinctness and precision, he cannot let me go, but will check all manner in his power to prevent scandal. This wouldn't happen. He's not a man, a machine, and a spiteful machine makes angry. I know how hard it is for a truthful nature to lie, and I grieve for you. All of a sudden, you have ruined your whole life for me.
No, I was just thinking the very same thing. How could you sacrifice all yourself for my sake? I cannot forgive myself if you are unhappy.
I'm happy? I'm like a hungry man who has been given food. And maybe clothes, and dressed in rags. I'm ashamed. I think it's not unhappy. Unhappy? No. This is my happiness. Tonight, at 1 o'clock, we're overboard. I must soon be getting ready for the races. Betsy promised to fetch me.
Improperly. and I wish this would not occur. Possibly I was mistaken.
No, you were never mistaken. I will earn his mistrust. I love him. I hear you, but I'm thinking of him. I hate you, I can't bear you, I'm afraid of you. You can't let her do that.
Well, very good. But I expect a strict form of observation of the form of property. I must take steps to secure my honor. I sent to Alexei to find out how it is. He writes me it's quite well and unhurt. But he is ill.
Writes to me that there is nothing she longs for so much as quiet and solitude.
Uh-huh. It's better.
Thank God, she's quite well again, and I believe her lungs are affected.
Oh, I'm very glad.
Let me ask you, Constantine Dimitrievich, why is you angry with Kitty?
Me? I'm not angry with her.
Yes, you are angry. Why was you not come to visit us not long when you were in Moscow?
Well, Dr. Zama, I really wonder that with our kind heart of figures. If nothing else, what do you know?
What do I know?
You know my girlfriend, I wonder if you.
What make you suppose I know?
Because everyone knows it.
That's very mistaken. I never know it, though I had guessed it was so.
Now you know it.
All I knew was that something had happened when her dreadfully miserable, and she begged me never to speak of it. And if she would not tell me, she would certainly not speak of it to anyone else. But what did it pass between you? Tell me.
I have to.
Well, what was it?
Well, I will enter your house all the time.
Do you know that I'm awfully, awfully sorry for her? The suffering from pride.
I'm so what?
But she, poor girl, I'm awfully, awfully sorry for her. Now I see it all.
Well, darling, I'm afraid that I have to go. Goodbye, girl.
No! Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Sit down.
Please, don't let us talk about this.
I did not know you. If I did not like you, as I do know you, I understand that. You cannot understand. For you men, whom are free and make your own choice, it's always clear whom you love. But a girl in a position of suspense, with all woman or maiden's modesty, a girl who steals your man from a fear, who takes everything on trust. A girl may have and often has such a feeling that she cannot tell what to say.
Yes, if the heart does not speak.
No, the heart does speak. But just consider, you may have views about a girl. You come to the house, you make friends, you criticize, you wait to see you have found what you love. You are sure you love her, you make her an offer.
That's not fair.
And you will make an offer. But her girl is not us. She expects to make her own choice. But she could not choose. She can only answer yes or no.
Darling, that's how one chooses a mistress or purchase or other. I like love. The choice has been made so much better, and there can be no repeating it.
But pride, pride. At the time we made Kitty an offer, she was in a position she could not answer. She was in thought. But between you and Ronsky, him, she was seeing every day, and you, she haven't seen for a long while. Supposing she has been older, I, for instance, would have no doubt. I always dislike him, not has turned out.
Oh, yeah. I really appreciate your kindness to me, but I believe you're making me think. When I'm not around that, perhaps you so despise me, thanks a lot, okay? Kitty, I'm to draw now to question for me, you know.
I will say only one thing. I am here speaking of my own sister, whom I love as I love my own children. I do not mean she cared for you. I need to say that her refusal at that moment means nothing.
I don't know. If you want to know how your heart beats, just let me go after she's not there. And they want to say to you, he could be like this, like that. He could have these, and how happy you could be with him. But he's dead!
How scared you are. No, I see it all more and more clearly. So you won't come to visit us when Katie's here?
No, sure. Of course, I won't avoid meeting Katie and Jordan, but as far as I can, I'll save her from the boy something like this.
You're very, very upstairs. But where are you going? Who's
there, little? Secretary, mother, but I'm afraid that I have to go.
Okay, I'll pay your carriage.
Goodbye, Jackson, gentlemen. For me. Maybe I can live for Costco, and by then I shall be a member of the community and marry a pilgrim girl. What am I going to do? I have to see the honor, though I cannot think of anything ever working on it. But one thing is certain that this night I decided my fate. All my own dreams of home life were reserved, not a real thing. It was so much, sometimes there. How beautiful. How exquisite the art is in this exquisite night. And when was time for it, I touched the floor. Just now, in the sky, there was nothing else. Just the red streets. I saw impossibility to my life, to my view of life changed. What's that? Someone coming. No. However good enough for that, simplicity and the toy baby, I cannot go back to it.
Tell you yesterday. They're coming home with Axie and Sandra. I told him everything. I told him I could not get his wife.
Yes. Yes, that's better. A thousand times better. I know how painful it is. So, throw everything and come with me.
It was not in the least painful to me. It happened on itself. And see,
I understand. The one thing I prayed for, the one thing I longed for, is to devote all my self to your happiness.
Why don't you tell me that? Just suppose I can tell you.
There's someone coming, perhaps they know it.
You see, that's what a man he is.
Forgive me, but I rejoice at it. Forgive me. Please let me finish, for God's sake. I rejoice at it, because things cannot remain as he supposes.
What can there?
Not. I hope that... Hold on, we will leave him. And I hope that you let me arrange our life tomorrow.
But my child, you see what he writes. I should have to leave him. And I can't, I won't do that.
Karenina, which is better? You, your child, were staying in this degrading position.
To whom is it degrading?
To all, and mostly to you.
Is it degrading? Don't say that. Those words have no meaning for me. Don't you understand that from the day I loved you, everything has changed for me? For me, there's one thing, and one thing only. Your love. If it's mine, I feel so exalted, so strong, that nothing can be humiliating to me. I'm proud of my possession. Because part of...
Anna, it's not a divorce possible. Could you take your son and still leave him?
Yes. But it all depends on him. Now I must go to him.
On Thursday, I will be in Pittsburgh. And everything.
Yes, but don't let us talk any more of it. I'm a guilty woman. I'm a bad woman. But I'm the same as the worst, as I told you then. And I have come to tell you that I can change nothing.
I told you. I write it to you. And I repeat now. I'm not bound to notice. I ignore. Not all the wife are so kind as you. To be in such a hurry to communicate such agreeable news with their husband. I shall ignore this so that the world knows nothing of it. So that my name is not disgraced. And I simply inform you that our relationship must be the always thing. And only in the event you compromise me, I shall fix death to the secure of my honor.
But our relations can't be the same as always. I cannot be your wife,
The manner of life you have chosen is reflected, I suppose. In your opinion, I have too much respect for content, of course. I respect your past and despise your present. I'm far away from the interpretation you put on my work. So indeed I feel to comprehend the independence you keep, but apparently you can see anything reprehensible in performing your wife's duty in relation to your husband.
Alexandrovich, what is it you want of me?
I want you not to meet the man here. And in return, you will enjoy the privilege of a peaceful wife without fulfilling the duty. That's all I have to say to you. Now it's time to go. I'm not dying at home today.
one is producing that book. Coachman!
Oh, sir?
Hurry, buy some lapis. Hurry up! Okay, sorry. What are these things?
Sir, here you are.
Am I late?
You can never have been late.
I love your hair. Who's here?
Oh, sir. Please here.
Well, you must meet my senior. I saw you were driving from a railway station to Akashoba. You were driving to Akashoba at that moment.
Excuse me, but I give my word that I will introduce company to Ms. Karen.
Oh, sure.
Let me introduce you, Mr. Lab. This is Mr. Karen. Mr. Karen, this is Mr. Lab.
Very glad to meet you again.
You are acquainted.
Yeah, we have spent 3 hours in the train. I just got out and in the microwave. I missed it, I don't know. And here's I was.
Nonsense. Let's have a dinner, shall we? Oh. Wow. Have you been gymnastics a bit? Oh, what do I sense? A perfect sense, sir.
I imagine this stress is needed for hunting beers.
No, on the contrary, your child is going to be beer. When I'll be hunting in your province, you know, coming back from the next ambition boat today, or your boat rest brother-in-law, it was a mutant teaching. The conductor, forgetting the program, at first would have changed their kind of attire, but they are having an increasing feelings in invalid language, and at first issue would have dejected me on the ground of old coat. After that, you come apart for which I'm extremely grateful.
The Royal Passenger is the best seat.
I saw you were in a certain bunny, so I just made it easier to smooth over the effects of my time. It was very exciting in the morning. You remember just a week? Your mother was sitting in the corner, and I was working in a laundry cookie in your friend's hand. It was a splendid set of glasses. And I think you flashed by. I saw you. You were sitting like this, holding the strings of tea caps with both hands, and thinking deeply of all things about it. How could I think about it at the same time?
Really, I don't remember. How was it said about?
Well, there was nothing. Have you known him as?
And I see you think he's an old man.
Not hurry, but nothing here.
No, you're wrong.
Yeah. thought you were going to work to Georgia. That's something different country.
No, it
wasn't
into fashion country.
Wait, I have not wanted to ask you your question. Said what you like.
We will talk it over then. Your benediction and announcements can be placed down as we will.
I know so. I don't hold a void. And yes, I have always sure that it was ordered.
eternal God who joins them that will separate, and pause a name for them and the soul that we are. Though, Rubidus, blessed is not ever remember, and yes, that I promise they is. Blessed is my servants, Constantine and Peter, and lead them on the path of righteousness, most merciful God, Father of men, we praise thee. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, now and hereafter, and forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The servant of God, Constantine, let's be trusted to the servant of God. One day.
still find that I long to leave the country. There's nothing to keep here, is there?
I just want to change my
clothes and what is that? Even I came to him was like an inspiration. Why went here for the divorce? Or maybe he just seemed to be in the country. I can't wait any longer. I don't want to go home. I don't want to hear anything about the divorce. It shall not have any more influence in my life. Do you agree? What did you do?
Well,
who was there?
Well, in Moscow, they never did anything without someone particular. A lady on the scene, a student teacher of the speaking, gave us an explanation of her skill. Well then, when do you think to go?
Hey, the sooner the better. But tomorrow we shan't be ready. The day after tomorrow.
The day after tomorrow? Yes. Oh, wait a minute. The day after tomorrow is Sunday, right? I must be very home.
Can't you go tomorrow?
No.
Yes, sir, I won't go at all.
But for what?
I shall not be later, Monday or never.
Why?
There's no meaning to you because you care nothing for me. You don't care to understand my life. The one thing that I care for him is Hannah, but you said I don't love my daughter.
I never said
that. How is it that you boast of your straightforwardness? You don't tell the truth.
I never tell lies, and I never boast.
With that possibility to cover the empty place where love should be, and if you don't love me anymore, it would be better to say so.
I cannot bear it. What do you try my patience for? It has limits.
What do you mean by that?
I will say, what is
happening? What can I want? All I can want is that you should not desert me, as you are thinking of doing. I will love, and there's no, so then all is over.
Stop, stop! What happened? I just stayed full of for 3 days, and because of that, you see, I was lying and I'm not an honorable man.
Yes, and I repeat that man who reproaches me with having sacrificed everything for me, that is worse than this honorable man. It's heartless, man.
My patience has limits.
It is me. That's clear. If I send as a woman, it's even clearer. I will love, and there's not. So there, all is over. And must be Annie.
Emma, we'll go the day after tomorrow, and I'll arrange everything. What?
You know, cast me off. I'll go away tomorrow. I'll do more. What am I? An immortal woman. A storm on your neck. I don't want to make you wretched. I don't want to. What's that, afraid?
Emma.
You don't love me. You love someone else.
Emma, why distress yourself with me so?
Can it be all over? No, that cannot be. He will come back. But how can he explain just now? That excitement after he had been talking to her. But even if he doesn't explain, I will believe. If I don't believe, there is only one thing left for me. And I can't. By now, he's received a note that he's coming back. Not long, 10 minutes more. But what if
it doesn't come?
No, that cannot be. He must have seen me with tears in eyes. I'll go and watch, yes.
Did I do my hair or not? Yes, my hair being done. But when I did it, I can use it as a reminder. What is it? Why? I'm going out of my mind. How do you look at me as something dreadful, incomprehensible, and curious? Can I ever tell anyone what one is feeling? I met with Dolly, and it's good thing I didn't tell her. How pleased she would have been at misery. She would have concealed it, but her true feeling had been delight and been punished for the happiness in me before. Kitty, she would have even been more pleased. How I can see through her. She knows I was more than eerily sweet to her husband, and she envies me and hates me, and she despises me. In her eyes, I'm a dishonorable woman. Well, if I am an immoral woman, I would have made her husband fall in love with me. If I could care to. And indeed, I did care to. There's someone else, please, let's consult. Something near me. Well, it must be me as far as anyone in the world knows me. I don't know myself. We all want what is sweet and nice. If not sweet means little dirty eyes. And Kitty is the same. If not Vronsky, then Levin. And she envies me and hates me. And we all hate each other. Yes, that's the truth. But telling them when it comes. And there's nothing moving, nothing merciful, really. It's all hateful. And this thing and this humbug simply to conceal the fact that we all hate each other. Here's an answer.
I will say it to me.
And hasn't the last one come back? Then, this is so. And what I must do, I'll go to him myself. Before going away, however, I'll tell him it all. Never have I hated anyone except his Emma. Yes, I must go quickly. I must go to the railway station. And if he's not there, then go there and catch him. And that's one reason was given me for to escape. Why not put out the line when there's nothing more to look at? And we're just seeking to look at it all. Why is the conductor wrong on the food board? Why is he shrieking, this young man in that train? Why is it talking? Why is it laughing? It's all falsehood, all lying, all cruelty, all humbug. What's that question I was a look from Count Vronsky?
Count Vronsky? He's not here, the Princess Karenina and her daughter. And what does Kuchiman like?
Who's been here? It's red and in his smart blue coat.
Sure, yes, I will.
No.